War. On December 7, 1941, the United States of America was dragged into one of the most significant conflicts in the history of the human race, following an unprecedented attack by the Japanese on the naval base at Pearl Harbor. Soon after, men, women, and children across the country began to contribute all that they could to the war effort. How did the girls of Georgia State Women's College respond? Let's take a look. One of the ways our GSWC girls served their country was by selling war bonds, putting money right into the pocket of Uncle Sam himself. As a matter of fact, when the college sponsored the Fourth War Loan and Red Cross drives here in our own little Lowndes County, Georgia, they managed to exceed expectations each time. Congratulations, girls. Keep up the good work. And keep up the good work they certainly did. Aside from selling war bonds, the GSWC girls also collected scrap metal and paper, both of which were used to produce valuable and vital military equipment. Remember, girls, our boys overseas are counting on you. One of the most important things our girls here at GSWC did for the troops was roll bandages for the Red Cross. You can see how they all gathered together, hair covered up, to roll them. Once the bandages were made, they were shipped overseas and used to keep the troops in tip-top shape. Because of you, girls, our boys can fight for freedom today and keep fighting tomorrow. While all of the girls' other contributions were certainly important, the most important thing to happen to GSWC was the opening of Moody Air Force Base in 1942. Bombs and bullets and bandages are fine and dandy, but there is one thing our soldiers can't get overseas: the chance to spend time with the wonderful gals of Georgia State Women's College. When the base got up and running, GSWC hosted several dances and events to give the airmen a chance to have some fun and improve morale. As you can see here, all those efforts were quite successful. Just look at them all having a rip-roaring time. Much like all patriotic people at the time, the fine ladies of Georgia State Women's College did everything they could to help the war effort, even when it cost them celebrations like May Day and the Old English Christmas Festival. When tyranny came a-knocking and Uncle Sam called for help, Georgia State Women's College answered with bonds, scrap, bandages, and morale boosters. Great work, ladies.